What are the concerns with social media influencing our news streams today and how we're consuming information today?
I think there's a lot of emphasis on the part of the journalists to follow what's getting hits. And that's not necessarily a new problem. It's something that happened in TV all the time. When we used to get our ratings, you knew which articles did well, which articles didn't, and you ended up reporting on things that maybe you didn't find journalistically interesting, but you knew were going to get you ratings. That O.J. Simpson trial is a great example of that. The royal wedding recently mm-hmm. is another great yeah. example of that. There were a lot of coverage of that, despite the fact that journalistically, probably not where you need to be focusing your attention. Journalists know that, mm-hmm. but they deal with it because they have to. Now it's starting to get to the point of which articles, which times of day are doing well, and how do I get Google to link back, and how do I get other people to link back, and from a PR perspective, as you're pitching articles, if your article doesn't get a lot of hits, when you put your client out there, they might not come back to your client. Mm-hmm. If you're a reporter and you're writing, my concern is that they're starting to follow where the hits are, and Ed brought up a great point of there's something about picking up a newspaper and serendipitously finding the right article. Mm-hmm. There's something you didn't know you wanted to know.
Right.
And that's what's getting lost as we're picking and choosing our news sources and as we're following just what some people are interested in, mm-hmm. is finding something you didn't know. Mm-hmm. You needed to know since it's new.
Are we now just entering perhaps a digital version of people walking by a newsstand and seeing graphic images or sexy images on newsstand covers?
Well, that was always the difference between the broadsheet and the tabloid, right?
Right.
The tabloid sold at newsstands. The broadsheet was subscription-based. Yes, we are still running into that problem of where the links are coming. Google News feeds you the most interesting linked upon news and things that it decides are important. But people are also choosing their sources and choosing their sources in ways that might not be always positive. Rather than trying to say, well, gee, I think liberally, but maybe I should read some conservative blogs. People are saying, I think liberally, so I'm going to read only liberal blogs, or I'm going to friend people who think like me on Facebook. And then Facebook, as you're linking on those friends, Facebook only feeds you those friends. So you mm-hmm. end up losing those people that maybe you don't interact with. And suddenly, you're just in an echo chamber. You're hearing things that you want to hear. They're reinforcing your thoughts. But you're not hearing the other side of the argument. And instead of having a conversation, and a true conversation, people are ingrained into their own way of thinking, even more so. And I think this is leading to polarizations within politics. And you can see it happening on Capitol Hill.